Today, I'm going to show you how to rewire propeller heads Reason to Pro Tools. This would allow the user to fully integrate the incredibly powerful synthesizers which are built into Reason into your Pro Tools session. Whenever using rewire, you must open the master application first, in this case Pro Tools, and then any subsequent rewire slave applications, in this case Reason. Looking at the hardware interface front panel, Reason has set itself up in rewire slave mode. This means that all sound from Reason can only be audible via rewire master application. Because we're going to be sequencing in Pro Tools, I'm now going to shut down Reason's sequencer window. It's also important to check the keyboards and control surfaces preference pane to ensure that your MIDI controller keyboard is not being used within Reason. While we're still here in Reason, I'm going to create an instance of Thor and one of Subtractor. The tab key switches between the front and the back of Reason's rack. As you can see, Thor has automatically patched itself into the hardware interface using audio outs 1 and 2. Rewire calls these mix left and mix right. I'm going to manually patch Subtractor to audio out 3. On the Mac, a really useful shortcut to switch between active applications is to hold the Command key and press Tab. Back in Pro Tools, I'm going to start by setting up the audio routing. Create one stereo and one mono instrument track and name them accordingly. In the Thor instrument track, insert an instance of the Reason Rewire plugin. We can see the Rewire channel has defaulted to Mix Left Right, which, as I mentioned earlier, is what Reason refers to as audio outputs 1 and 2. Now I'm going to do the same for the Subtractor instrument, but change the Rewire channel to channel 3. Now I will set up the instrument tracks to route the MIDI performance data to the Reason instruments. From the MIDI editor window, I'm going to draw in a few notes to test the setup. I'd like to be able to add a filter sweep to Subtractor. I could do this from Reason Sequencer, but this could cause difficulties later when arranging a track. It can be simpler to keep all your program data in the same application. Unfortunately, this is not as straightforward as you would like, but worth the effort now for time saved later. If you go to the Applications Reason Documents folder, you'll find the MIDI implementation chart. This shows you all the control numbers for parameters in Reason. It's worth noting that Reason uses the industry standard of control chain 74 for all instrument filter cutoff controls, though. In Pro Tools, I'm going to open the automation lane, and using the drop-down menu, I'll add controller 74. Add a new lane and set it to our newly available controller value. I will quickly draw in a curve to test this with. That's about all for today. See you next time.